Good morning, class. Today we are going to learn chapter number 4, absorption by roots. Yeah, let me share the screen now. Yes, class. This is part 1 video, chapter 4, absorption by roots. What is meant by root absorption? You know, plant roots. Plant roots absorbs water as well as mineral salts from the soil, right? You pour water to the roots, but not on the over of what leaves or stem, right? So water will be collected between the soil particles. Soil particles, definitely it has a space. Within that space, water is filled. Along with water, even minerals which are present in soil is absorbed by roots. What exactly, which part of the root absorbs this water as well as minerals? Yes, it's a root hair. So root absorbs water from the soil through root hair by osmosis. Roots are the fine branches. Again, each branch has one cell thick, only one cell layer thick root hair. It absorbs water through the process of osmosis and diffusion. What is meant by osmosis? The movement of water molecules from the region of higher concentration towards the region of lower concentration. Osmosis takes place only liquid or fluids. Fluids or liquids move from the region of higher concentration towards the region of lower concentration through the process of osmosis. But diffusion only in the cases of gases. Exactly the same, but here the example is gas. I will give you one best example. You know, incentive six sticks are perfume. If I spray perfume here, throughout the room the fragrance spreads. How? Through the process of diffusion. What is meant by diffusion? Movement of gaseous molecules from the region of higher concentration towards the region of lower concentration. Osmosis, again say, but here the movement of fluid particles or water. And then it is transported. After diffusion or osmosis, what will happen? It is transported by the cortical cells, the outermost layer of cells, and xylem vessels to different parts of the plant under the influence of various forces and pressure. Once water is absorbed by the root cells or root hair cells, this water is transported towards the aerial parts of the plant by cortical cells and first by cortical cells and then by xylem vessels to different parts of the plant under the influence of various forces and pressure. That forces as well as pressure I will explain you in this chapter. So the soil water contains soil water in the sense, you know, the water which is present in soil. The soil water contains a variety of inorganic salts dissolved in soil are nitrates, sulfates, fluorides, carbonates, potassium, calcium, sodium, magnesium, iron, and manganese. I repeat, the soil water contains, the water which is present in soil contains variety of inorganic salts, which is dissolved in it in the form of solution. Keep it in mind, when salts are dissolved in water, then it is called solution. Always salts are available in solution form. What are those salts? Nitrates, sulfates, fluorides, carbonates, potassium, calcium, sodium, magnesium, iron, and manganese. So plants will get both water as well as mineral salts. All these are mineral salts. So, what are essential elements? Essential elements in the sense, the elements which are required by plants, which are very essential, without which plants cannot grow. There will be a deficiency. So, what are those? It's potassium, calcium, magnesium, iron, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, and phosphorus. Trace essential elements, elements which are required in less quantity or minute amount. What is that? Manganese, zinc, copper, molybdenum, and boron. These are required in trace amounts or less quantity. Role of water in the life of a plant. What is the role of water? Why water is required for the plant? Let us see now. Water. Water constitutes more than 80% of the cell protoplasm. You have seen cytoplasm as well as nucleoplasm, right? So here, 80% of cytoplasm as well as nucleoplasm is made by water, which is essential for the normal functioning of a cell. Here, water created by the plant to carry out various water which is provided to the plant carry out various processes such as photosynthesis and transpiration. Water is required by the plant to carry out various processes like photosynthesis, transpiration and transportation of food. For photosynthesis, water is essential. For transpiration in the sense loss of water in the form of water vapor to the aerial parts of a plant. And transportation of food. Food is synthesized in leaves. But what about stem and other parts of a plant like roots? How they get food? Through the phloem. So transportation of food takes place even through phloem only in the presence of water. Water is a universal solvent. Minerals and organic compounds and many gases are dissolved in it. Water is a universal solvent. It can dissolve many salts and even organic compounds and gases dissolved in it. Water is essential for the production, transport and activity of enzymes. Water is essential for production of food, transportation of food and even activity of enzymes. Water provides turgidity to the cells, seeds, radicals to penetrate the soil. Water provides turgidity, swelling of cells and even seeds, even the formation of radicals or roots that should penetrate to the soil. What are the adaptations of the roots for water absorption? How roots are adapted for water absorption? There should be some adaptations or changes in roots which will be helpful for absorption of more water and mineral salts. Let us see what are those adaptations. Roots are positively geotrophic. Geotrophic in the sense the movement of roots towards the earth or soil. So roots are positively geotrophic since roots grow into the soil and go deeper and deeper towards the gravity, the source of water. Therefore, they are called positively geotrophic. They can absorb more water. Roots have very large surface area. You might have seen roots will grow underground, right? It will spread throughout the land or that surrounding area. So here, 200 roots per square millimeter. Just imagine 200 roots, root hairs per square millimeter increases the surface area of a root for increased absorption of water and minerals. As we know already, if the surface area is more, automatically the absorption rate will be more. Roots contain concentrated cell sap. The salt concentration inside the cell sap is more. If the salt concentration is more, automatically it absorbs more water. It should be more concentrated. If it is dilute, it will absorb less water. So roots contain always concentrated cell sap. Root hair contains some sugars as well as salt called cell sap. Sap in the sense, you know, the thing which is stored in vacuole. That cell sap should be. So vacuole contains reserved food materials as well as other non-required materials totally together called cell sap. If the concentration of cell sap is more, automatically the root hair cells absorbs more water. Root hair have thin wall. In root hair, the cell wall is permeable and cell membrane is selectively permeable. See, root hair cell, definitely a cell outermost layer in plant cell is cell wall. Next to that, there is a cell membrane, right? So cell wall is freely permeable. It allows each and every substance to pass through it, either inside or outside. But cell membrane is selectively permeable. It allows only few substances to pass or to move inside as well as outside the cell. See, this is the structure of root as well as root hair. See, this is one of the part of a section of a root along with one root hair. How many root hairs are there? Only one root hair here. See, this is root hair. It is absorbing substances here. See, this is vacuole. These are soil particles. See, this is epidermis. Epidermis in the sense the outermost layer of a root, epidermis in the sense outermost part of a plant body, wherever you see, either it may be a stem or leaf or root, the outermost layer of cells in a plant body is nothing but epidermis, outermost part of a plant body. Next to the epidermis, what you can see, see the cortex. And after the cortex, see how water will transport from root hair to epidermis and then to cortex and then towards the endodermis, the inner layer of a cell. And this is xylem. The purple color, pink and purple color one indicates xylem. And next to that, at sideways, you can see phloem. If xylem is there, in between xylem and phloem, you can see cambium. These green are cambium cells, which are meristematic in nature, which keeps on adding xylem as well as phloem cells. So phloem conducts food, and here xylem conducts water. So transportation is continuous. This is pericycle, present next to the endodermis. Ectodermis or epidermis, outer layer of cell. Endodermis, inner layer of cell. After endodermis, there is a pericycle, and then phloem, then cambium, and then xylem, exactly at the center pith. Next. Factors affecting the absorption of water. What are the factors that affects the absorption of water? Soil temperature. An increase in temperature, either increase or decrease in temperature causes a decrease in the rate of absorption of water. So always absorption of water takes place at moderate room temperature. Temperature should not be too high or it should not be too less. It should be average. Concentration of soil solution. I told you already, if the cell sap of a root hair is more concentrated, if it is more concentrated than that of the surrounding soil water, the water enters the root hair and balances the concentration. Like that, here concentration is maintained. If the cell sap concentration is less, here concentration is already less, so no more absorption of water takes place. If the concentration is more, cell sap concentration or salt concentration is more, automatically plant cells should maintain balance within its cell sap. So to maintain balance, it's absorb water. Next, aeration of soil. Of course, well aerated, aeration in the sense, so there should be a supply of gases. Well aerated soil facilitates absorption of most soil water by the root hairs. Only aerated soil, well aerated soil can provide more water. The absorption of water and minerals from the soil by the root hair and its conduction takes place by four processes. I told you, after absorption, how the water molecule reaches the xylem under that parts of a plant body. Let us see now. It is through four processes. One is diffusion, including absorption of water by the root hair cells. It includes four processes, that is diffusion, osmosis, imbibition, and active transport. Now, let's discuss about diffusion, osmosis, imbibition, and active transport. Children, I'm telling you, these are very, very important concepts. Without these definitions, without understanding what are the terms, what is mean by diffusion, osmosis, imbibition, and active transport, you cannot understand this lesson. So listen carefully. What is mean by diffusion? What is the difference between, main difference between diffusion, osmosis, and imbibition, and even active transport? So let us study about diffusion first. What is mean by diffusion? What exactly is the diffusion? Where it takes place? Let us see now. diffusion in the sense, here it is a movement of gases or liquids. Diffusion takes place, diffusion here, what are the materials where you can see diffusion? Gases as well as liquids and even molecules or ions of a solute. From the region of here, the movement of either gases or liquid like water or ions of a solute like sodium as well as chloride or any other salts you take, ions, positive or negative ions you take. So from where these materials move, from the region of higher concentration, its concentration should be more. From there, the movement of molecules takes place towards the region of lower concentration. When come in direct contact, but there should be a direct contact between this higher as well as lower concentration. In plants, diffusion occurs when root has come in contact with the soil. So where is higher concentration and where is lower concentration? Imagine these are roots and this is soil. Roots are present within soil, right? Like this. So where should be the higher and where should be higher? Where should be lower? So water concentration will be always high in soil, but in roots, the water concentration is less. So water movement takes place from the soil towards the root. Why? Because always diffusion takes place from the region of higher concentration towards the region of lower concentration. They should be in contact. Importance of diffusion. What is the use of this diffusion? Exchange of gases during respiration takes place through diffusion. You know, what is meant by respiration and photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is a process through which plants prepare their own food. What is respiration? Once food is prepared, it should be broken down. It should be break down to release energy. That process is nothing but respiration. But here, the required gases are always different. For photosynthesis, carbon dioxide is required. For respiration, oxygen is required. How this carbon dioxide as well as oxygen enters into the plant body? Through the process of diffusion. The loss of water in the form of water vapor from the leaves takes place by diffusion. Again, transpiration. It takes place through the surface of leaf during daytime, right? When sunlight is more, water will be lost in the form of water vapor. How this transpiration takes place? Through the process of, again, diffusion. Movement of water molecules from the region of higher to lower concentration. Even diffusion, you can give examples as gases, not only water. Diffusion spreads molecules and ions throughout the protoplasm. Here, exchange of materials or exchange of gases as well as other contents or materials takes place within plant body through the process of diffusion again. Very, very important concept. Next, osmosis. What is the major difference between diffusion and osmosis? Osmosis may be defined as the passage of solvent molecules from the region of higher to the region of lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Here, only movement of water molecules takes place. Only the movement of solvent, but not the gases. Always osmosis takes place in liquids or solvent. From the region of, again, higher to lower concentration. But in between, there should be a semi-permeable membrane. Whether it is between soil as well as root, whether it is between air as well, few more examples. Between the cell or cell, there should be a semi-permeable membrane. Transportation takes place through semi-permeable membrane. Next. For diffusion, semi-permeable membrane is not required, not necessary. It may require, it may not be. Osmosis in plant cells occurs through the cell membrane. The plant cell in pure water takes place by osmosis through its selectively permeable cell membrane. See, here is a picture. See, it depicts osmosis. Look here. This is exactly at the center. You can see semi-permeable membrane. Here, can you see the red color dots? These are water molecules. And blue color one are solutes. Solute. Or you take any salt. Say, for example, sodium chloride, salt. Blue color one indicates salt. Red color one indicates water. Here, blue color one indicate, again, salt. And red color one indicate water. Here salt concentration is less, so low solute. Here salt concentration is more. Salt is here, see 1, 2, 3. Here salt concentration is more. So from where water molecules move? From the region of higher concentration. If solute concentration is less, definitely the solvent or water concentration is more. Here water concentration is less. So movement of water takes place from the region of higher concentration towards the region of lower concentration, called osmosis, through a semi-permeable membrane. Only the movement of water, I repeat, only the movement of water molecules from the region of, red color one indicates water here, from the region of higher concentration, water concentration here is higher, here it is lower, so it will move through a semi-permeable membrane. What is the importance of osmosis in plants? Absorption of water from the soil by the root hair takes place through osmosis. The movement of water molecules from one cell to the other takes place through, again, osmosis. Osmosis helps in maintaining the structure and the form of different organs of a plant body. The force exhibited by the concentrated cell, a solution on the water molecules to let it move from outside to inside the cell through a semi-permeable membrane, is called osmotic pressure. What is mean by osmotic pressure? The force or the pressure exerted by the concentrated cells in a solution on a water molecule is called osmotic pressure. I repeat again, osmotic pressure in the sense the pressure exerted by the cell. The pressure exerted by the cells in a solution on water molecules. When pressure is exerted by the cell on water molecules, now the water molecules will move from outside to inside a cell through a semi-permeable membrane. Okay, in the next class, we are going to study about types of solution, that is isotonic, hypertonic and hypertonic. Go through this video, children. If you have any doubts, we will discuss in live class.